Hello friends, so let's start our next part. Equipment based questions. So we'll start with the supraglottic equipments. Equipments you know can be supraglottic or infraglottic. So broadly they are classified as airway devices. Broadly we classify as supraglottic and infraglottic. So as the name suggests, supraglottic means which are remaining above the glottis, and infraglottic means which are below the vocal cords. And infraglottic devices are definite airway devices are infraglottic. So this infraglottic includes endotracheal tube and tracheostomy. So endotracheal tube and tracheostomy are considered as definite airway because they are below the glottis. So to call some airway device is definite, it has to be below the glottis, means you should place a tube in trachea and ventilate through that tube. Rest all will be supraglottic devices. So the question is, you can look at the equipment. So the disadvantage of this equipment: increased dead space, increased chance of aspiration, prolonged use is tiring. This is face mask, and face mask can be used only as a tied over face till you are able to achieve the definite airway. So face mask can be used only as a tied over face till you are able to achieve the definite airway. Why? Because mask ventilation carries many disadvantages. One, you require technical expertise. It's not that you think anybody can do the mask ventilation. No, there have to be specific position for ventilating with mask. Means first you have to achieve you have to prevent airway obstruction, and you know that the most common cause of airway obstruction is tongue fall. And when you are ventilating with the mask, so you have to also prevent tongue fall. It means you have to keep the patency of the airway, then only you will be able to ventilate with the mask. Means you have to achieve the position that is triple manual, that is head tilt, chin lift, and jaw thrust. Head tilt, chin lift, and jaw thrust, that is what you have to actually achieve to keep this airway open. Or else you can put a Goodell's airway. If that is there, you can put in Goodell's airway. So if Goodell's airway is not there, you have to achieve this position, and then only you will be able to ventilate the patient with masks. So it should be like that. Your three fingers should be lifting the mandible, and that will lead to head tilt. Head tilt means neck extension, and then your one finger should also be anteriorly displacing the mandible, and then your thumb and first finger should hold, will be holding the mask. So it is a technically expertise exercise, not simple exercise. And secondly, it is very tiring. Actually, you cannot hold mask for more than few minutes. It is very tiring to hold the mask. Then dead space is increased. obviously the volume contained in the mask is a dead space, so dead space volume is increased. Then wasted ventilation is high. You cannot achieve 100% seal to the face. Still there be leakage to the sides, and that can lead to wasted ventilation and increased pollution. And on top of that, the biggest disadvantage of mask ventilation is increased risk of aspiration. Risk of aspiration is tremendously increased with mask ventilation. When you give positive pressure with mask, air will leak into esophagus, will increase intragastric pressure, increasing the risk of aspiration. So the risk of aspiration is tremendously increased with mask ventilation. Therefore, any condition where there is increased risk of aspiration, bag and mask ventilation is contraindicated. Frequently asked question also. So bag and mask ventilation is contraindicated for all these situations where there is increased risk of aspiration, like say full stomach patients coming for emergency surgery, quite common. Patients with full stomach come for emergency surgery, or pregnant patients are so vulnerable for aspiration that sometimes they can aspirate spontaneously. That is called as Mendelssohn syndrome. So very high risk of aspiration. Then intestinal obstruction patient. Intestinal obstruction patient, their GI is full and vulnerable for aspiration, and they have Ryle's tube in place also, and Ryle's tube actually increase the risk of aspiration. Generally we think that Ryle's tube should decrease the risk of aspiration, but actually Ryle's tube increase the risk of aspiration. How? The most important protective mechanism against aspiration is the tone of lower esophageal sphincter. So putting Ryle's tube impair the tone of LES, so LES become incompetent, increasing the risk of aspiration, and you know it is impossible to completely evacuate the patient with Ryle's tube. So still there are significant contents which are present. Then anything which decreases the tone of lower esophageal sphincter, like say obesity, abdominal obesity, or during laparoscopic surgeries. So anything which actually increase the intra-abdominal pressure will lead to compression of stomach, leading to distortion of gastroesophageal angle, making LES to become incompetent, increasing the risk of aspiration. Then some neonatal emergencies which should be managed like where bag and mask ventilation is contraindicated is diaphragmatic hernia, tracheoesophageal fistula, meconium aspiration syndrome. So these emergencies should also be managed like rapid sequence induction, or you can say where bag and mask ventilation is contraindicated. So this aspiration is really very, very high risk of bag and mask ventilation. So the answer should be yes, it increases the dead space, it increases chance of aspiration, and the prolonged use is tiring. So all of the above. At this equipment, this device is used for ventilation, maintenance of airway, both none. This is actually Doodle's airway. Doodle's airway is actually used to prevent tongue fall. because you know that the most common cause of airway obstruction, I told you, is tongue falling back on posterior pharyngeal wall. So Gödel's airway we place like that, so that this portion lies in oropharynx. Lies in oropharynx means that will prevent this tongue falling back on posterior pharyngeal wall, that thus preventing the obstruction of airway, or other words you can say airway will be maintained, because you can see this is a hollow part, it is hollow from inside, so airway patency will be maintained. So this is Gödel's airway, which is used for the maintenance of airway. IGL, a very very important topic, or you can say the most important, if you ask me, device in current day is the laryngeal mask airway, LMA. If you ask me one particular instrument which has actually revolutionized anesthesia in last decade, I'll say is laryngeal mask airway. It has actually completely revolutionized the anesthesia practice, LMA. So laryngeal mask airway is like this. So this is a conventional, or you can say classical laryngeal mask airway. And this is a tube, and this is a cuff which can be inflated with volume of air. So it can be inflated with large volume of air. So once it get inflated, so we place it blindly, and obviously we inflate after placing it blindly, so that this part lies in oropharynx. Now when you inflate with the cuff, this inflated cuff will occupy whole of the oropharynx. Now if I ventilate through this tube, you can see these holes, ventilation holes. Through these holes, air has no option but to go to larynx. So actually, initially, when LMA was manufactured, it was used as an emergency device for failed or difficult intubation. So you're not able to intubate, no problem, you can put an LMA. Or if you feel intubation is difficult, you're struggling to intubate, as an alternative you can put an laryngeal mask airway. But over the years, when we started to use this LMA, we found it to be so effective method of ventilation that now we are using it as an elective procedure. Or elective equipment as an alternative to intubation. Initially, we were using it only for small duration surgeries. Now, but now we are using it for moderate or even longer duration surgeries in select cases. So now we are using it routinely for anesthesia as an alternative to intubation. So basically, what are the advantages of LME, the biggest advantage is that it avoid complications of general anesthesia. I mean, not exactly general anesthesia, you can say complications of intubation. Complications of intubation, and the most common complication of intubation, you know, is sore throat. This question they have asked number of times, which is the most common complication of intubation, and books you will see they have given so many, laryngeal edema or laryngeal injury, recurrent laryngeal injury, but they are so rare. While sore throat occurs in almost every second or third patient. So sore throat, then other complications, reflex responses to intubation. All reflex responses to intubation. And you know that intubation is one of the strongest sympathetic response of the body. So there can occur even severe tachyarrhythmias, malignant hypertension. So they can be prevented, or local response laryngospasm. So all complications related to intubation can be avoided. Then technically, easy to insert. It's a blind procedure. Even a paramedical staff can insert it. You have to just simply place it blindly. So even a paramedical staff can use it. So easy to insert. No specific position of neck is required. Otherwise, for intubation, you know, we have to achieve extension at atlanto-occipital joint and flexion at cervical spine. So for intubation, we have to achieve extension at atlanto-occipital joint and flexion at cervical spine. While there is no specific positions, means it can be placed in neutral position, making it an excellent for cervical spine fracture patients. You don't require laryngoscope. No laryngoscope is required. It's a blind procedure, so you don't even need a laryngoscope. No, actually, muscle accents required. Even muscle accents are not required. So it can be placed even in a awake patient, and every day in daycare we are doing this. We are using laryngeal mask airway and we are not using muscle relaxant. But nothing in this world has only advantages. There will be disadvantages also. One, if this LMA slips anteriorly, if it slipped anteriorly and touches the larynx, so it can induce laryngospasm. Then the biggest disadvantage or biggest limitation is that, you know, that it is just resting over the esophagus like this. It's just resting over the esophagus. It is not blocking the esophagus. So air can still leak from site, can increase intergastric pressure, increasing the risk of aspiration. So risk of aspiration. It's tremendously increased with this classical laryngeal mask here. Not exactly tremendously like mask ventilation, but yes, risk of aspiration is significantly increased with laryngeal mask airway. And the problem is that if there occur
gastric distension, if you are clearly seeing that air is leaking from the sides and patient's stomach is getting distended, you cannot deflate also, because from where you will pass your suction catheter rails to, the cuff of the LMA has completely occupied the oropharynx. So from where you will pass your suction catheter or Ryle's tube, so you cannot even deflate the stomach.
So considering these disadvantages, nowadays actually we are using second generation LMA. And the prototype of second generation LMA is Proseal. Proseal. So Proseal, there is a separate port. There will be separate tube in addition to this main tube. So this tube will pass through the cuff and then there is a hole here. So you can pass your suction catheter rise tube through this tube and then through this hole here, it will come out and will enter the esophagus and you can do the stomach decompression. So Proseal. So it has got additional tube for stomach decompression. Then another which is very commonly used is iGel. This in fact I'll say India is the most commonly used.
So iGel, as the name suggests, means the cuff is pre-filled with the gel. So that was our question also. So this is iGel. You can see that cuff of this LMA is pre-filled with the gel. So the advantage is that all complications related to cuff will be avoided. Like say accidentally this cuff get deflated. So there occur accidental deflation of the cuff. So if there occur accidental deflation of the cuff, LMA can get displaced, can go anteriorly touching the larynx or can rotate, obstructing the airway. Moreover, when you are removing LMA, the patient may bite this cuff. If the patient is not fully conscious, he or she may bite this cuff, damaging the cuff. So all these cuff related problems can be solved with iGel. And since iGel is a second generation LMA, so you can see that they have given a separate tube. You can pass your suction catheter rise tube through this inbuilt tube. And this tube will come out through this hole to enter the esophagus for stomach decompression. So iGel is very frequently used. Then another third generation LMA recently is the Supreme LMA. So Supreme LMA, what they have done? It's like Proseal, it's a second generation, so it will be like Proseal. Only thing is they have given a bite block here. Bite block, so they have given a bite block so that patient will not be able to bite this tube and damage this tube. Then LMA not only can be used as an alternative device for intubation, it can actually help in intubation. It can assist in intubation. But for that, we require a special LMA, that is intubating LMA. So the difference of intubating LMA from the normal LMA is that in intubating LMA, in place of these small ventilation ports, there is a big hole here. There is a big hole here. So you pass the LMA, start ventilating the patient with the LMA, then you can try a small size tube through this tube. You can try a small size endotracheal tube through this tube. So if you pass this small size endotracheal tube through this tube cannot slip anywhere. So through this hole, it will come out of this hole and will enter the larynx. So it can be used even in assisting the intubating LMA. And now, since LMA is so frequently used, so it is available, you can say, in almost 7 sizes. It is available in almost 7 sizes for all ages. Even for a newborn, you can use LMA, and the smallest size available is one number, and the largest size available is 6. Largest size available is 6, and most commonly that we can say used for adult males is 4 number, and for adult females is 3 number. Just a second. So what I was telling is, although I have seen a question where they have asked a LMA size for 15 kg boy, so actually see one or two questions comes like that, otherwise not possible to remember that which size you will be used for which age group. We also need to check the table, but yes, you can say most commonly used for adult males is 4 and for females is 3. Written also here, you can see 4 number is written, so it is for usually used for adult males, and here also they have written it should be less than 30. So see, it's not, again I told you, not possible to remember, so it's written not more than 30, and pressure should not be more than 60. Yes, that was the, I think, question asked somewhere in AIIMS, that pressure of this cuff should not be more than 60 centimeter of water. That's all I told you, is information is written on laryngeal mask airway. This is a single use. Otherwise, mostly LMA are reusable, and they can be reused up to 40 times. 40 times. And the best method of sterilization is ethylene oxide, ETO. Ethylene oxide gas sterilization. And this is not only applicable for LMA. Actually, all non, you can say, metallic equipments in anesthesia, they should be sterilized by ETO, ethylene oxide. This question.
obviously this IGF. That should be all for today. If you are planning to subscribe any regular course, then you can use my code Dr. Ajay Yadav 0712-3233 and you will get flat 10% discount. And there are a lot of courses which are coming on, like image based discussions, rapid revision, so many courses, small courses of anesthesia are coming up, so you can avail that benefit. And not only anesthesia, other subjects also you will get number of courses, and really nowadays subscription is really at very throwaway prices, so you can use it later also, and you can select what program you want, and accordingly you can choose that program. Okay, then. Thank you very much for joining.